Here we are again, people, and we'll just do another letter, which is the S, which is not quite like the other ones, but it still has those common elements which lead. You see what happens in rhythm? The eye travels, reads things by traveling along left or right, or in the Islamic world, I think you go the other way or whatever. It travels along, and a rhythm in the mind is established, you see. So lettering is designed that way. It's like music. So if suddenly there is an incorrect shape, the phenomena is that there's a sudden jarring effect in the mind, you might say. This is very fine psychology, you might say. But that's the actual phenomena of a rhythm which is not correct. Okay, good. So let's just do an S here. This is the way I, in this particular rhythmic pattern, I do an S, you see. So we go kind of like that, and we establish that element, and then we establish this element, and there's some sort of symmetry there, or some sort of rhythm, you might say, you see. And I might do this stroke here. Again, I'm echoing these other ones, you see. So there we have that. And then we just kind of finish it off like so. Okay, good. I must say, I'm not impressed with my expertise today. You understand? I'm getting a little older now and out of practice. But the days were when we'd zip through these sorts of jobs with great speed. And actually, that's not even a very nice looking S, but okay, fine, whatever. But it's in the same style. Oh, it's horrible, isn't it? Okay, fine. We won't worry too much about that. Gotta make allowances, you understand. Anyway, okay, get this job wrapped up. So again, we just follow the natural way that the hand works here. And there we go. And it should be something like that. This is the E. Okay. And there we go. Good. Okay, yep. So, and finally the R. And that stroke echoes all the other strokes. And we just finish that a bit there. Good. And all you people who sit at computers these days, and you just, it's all done for you. And I must say, vehicle lettering in its longevity is superior product to sign painting, I have to say. Especially red letters, when they're sign painted, they don't weather well. Also blues don't weather well. Black, yeah, good. And one of the disadvantages of when you sell your van, of sign painted van, is that you usually had to get the van for your jobs, for your company or whatever. You used to have to get it refinished before the next signs went on it. So a signed van in the old days would not have a premium value. Well, these days, all you do is you get a pressure washer or something, and you just zip your letters off. I mean, yes, it's a superior product. Yes, I'm sorry. Well, anyway, I guess there's still some role for old-fashioned sign painters, refinishing the HMS Victory, stuff like that, maybe on old railway engines or something, Oh, yeah. Anyway, okay, good. So here we go. And now that's interesting. You see, in the time I told you all of that, the colour or the paint on the brush has started to just go that little bit off, you see. So the sign painter at work, he has to, you know, be up with the conditions minute by minute, and he can't sort of stop and talk to somebody for a few minutes and then go back and expect the brush to be working exactly how it was, you see. So that's actually what's happened here. And now, do you notice, by the way, that I tend to use the brush not like that, but kind of a bit like an arrow sticking out of a target you just hit. You see, it's more your vertical kind of scenario, see, or perpendicular, that's the word.